Hello YouTube, this is Rick and Steve. Today we're going to be examining shotgun use in home defense roles. Specifically, we'll be looking at number 4 and number 8 shot when fired into pork ribs and testing the over-penetration through drywall into adjacent areas and judging the potential lethality for friendlies on the other side of those walls. One round of number 8 shot Federal Premium trap ammo out of a H&R Topper Model 88 12 gauge shotgun with a modified choke and 24 inch barrel. Okay, this is the entry wound side using the number 8 shot at 10 feet from the muzzle. And this is penetration through a second barrier located 4 feet. Okay, YouTube, we're using the same shotgun. This time we have substituted the Nitro Express number 4 shot turkey load, firing from 10 feet into drywall. This is the entrance side of the drywall at 10 feet using number 4 shot. This is the entrance side of the second sheet of drywall, 3 feet distance. All right, our next target of the day is a pork shoulder with a layer of pork ribs in front of those. We'll cover that with 4 layers of jean material and fire again using number 8 shot at a range of 10 feet from the muzzle.
All right, one round from the H&R 12 gauge shotgun, number 8 shot, Federal Birdshot.
All right, this is the entrance side of 4 layers of jean material, the exit side of the 4 layers of jean material, the underlying ribs. All ribs are completely broken, no shots observed inside the tissue. This is the pork shoulder that was immediately behind the ribs. The shot penetrated fully through the pork shoulder, leaving little to no shot in the meat. However, completely failed to penetrate the first layer of drywall immediately behind the meat. Okay, we are repeating the same test, this time using number 4 turkey load at a distance of 10 feet through 4 layers of blue jean material. We have pork ribs covering pork shoulder with drywall about 6 inches behind that.
Okay, 12 gauge shotgun, number 4 shot, high brass turkey load.
This is the entrance side of the blue jeans with the number 4 turkey shot. The exit side. This is the pork rib. The skin's folded over. Pretty much all ribs are obliterated. Here we have the entrance side of the pork shoulder and the exit wound through the back side. There are a large number of birdshot pellets remaining inside the meat. And this is the drywall, 6 inches behind. It looks like penetration was probably with the plastic wad, and there are a few pieces of birdshot penetrating the actual drywall. Okay, the last test will be Federal number 8 birdshot, muzzle range of 10 feet from drywall to test penetration on ballistics gelatin located 12 inches the other side of the second layer of drywall, simulating an interior wall.
We're looking at the bottom of the block here. We've turned it up on its side.
Number 4 shot, Remington high brass, through 2 layers of drywall into ballistics gel located 12 inches behind the second layer.
This is a number 8 birdshot cut shell at a distance of 10 feet, with the theory being that a cut shell will work as a glacier safety slug or similar self-defense round.
That's all the channel from the round itself. And there's a wad of pellets.
That gray dot is a wad of pellets. Oh, it is, yes.
Yeah.